Hi, I'm Mary Nielsen. I'm the Executive Director and Founder of Spectrum Advanced Aesthetics Institute, and I am thrilled to be able to introduce Christina Nelson, who is our Clinical Curriculum Coordinator. Christina is going to be demonstrating brow mapping.
Before mapping the brows, use a cotton round with an oil-based serum to cleanse and prep the skin. Hand your client a mirror so they can participate in the process. This can be helpful to establish client comfort and make sure you are both on the same page. Starting with the dimple of the nose, use a medical swab or wax stick and a white pencil to outline where the brows should begin. It should frame the bridge of the nose. Move to the end of the nose and use the pupil of the eye as a guide to find the client's arch. The client should be looking straight ahead towards the ceiling. Once you have determined this point, mark it with your pencil. Still using the end of the nose as your anchor, establish the tail of the brow by following the lower lash line as if it were to continue on. Use the pencil to mark here. After establishing where your client's brow should start, arch, and end, use your pencil to connect each mark. These lines will show your client what the ideal brow shape is for their particular facial features. It will also demonstrate which hair will be taken and which hair will be removed. Repeat this process for both brows. Begin the service by trimming the brows. Use your spoolie to direct the hair up, following the natural growth pattern, trimming all hair that extends above the white line. On the tail of the brow, direct the hair down, following the natural growth, and continue to trim. Keep your trimming conservative to start so that you don't create a gap in the brow. Repeat this process on the other side. If your trimmers are curved, be sure to rotate them so that they follow the curve of the brow. Let's turn one brow into two. Start by applying the wax in the middle with the direction of hair growth. Your wax should meet the lines you have created. Apply a wax strip, hold the skin taut, and pull parallel to the skin against the direction of hair growth. Apply a thin layer of wax below the brow from the start to the arch, covering the white line. Use a wax strip to remove against the direction of hair growth. Be sure to hold the skin taut to minimize lifting of the skin. Continue this process from the arch to the tail, applying with hair growth and removing against. Hold the skin taut with your hand or a spoolie to tweeze any remaining hair. You should be tweezing in the direction of hair growth. Tweezing at this point is more comfortable for the client than waiting until the end because inflammation hasn't set in yet. If you aren't sure if you should tweeze it, leave it and come back to it later. When finished, move on to wax above the brow, applying from the start to the arch, then the arch to the tail, making sure to cover the white line. Tweeze any remaining hair. Once you are happy with the outcome, hand the mirror to your client to give them the opportunity to make any changes before moving on to the other brow. When you both love it, repeat the same steps on the other brow. Be sure to take the mirror away from your client. After waxing both brows, make any final changes with your tweezers before finishing with aloe or a soothing serum. Hand your client the mirror one last time to show off your work. Thank you for watching this tutorial on brow mapping.